Hey guys, Devin here from American Aquarium. I want to talk to you about something that we kind of consider as a specialty around here at American Aquarium. And it's something that we talk to large corporations, universities, retail shops, and really everybody that comes to us through our website at American Aquarium. And we may talk about it in different ways, but the end result is that we're trying to get the same message across. This is something that we did not discover, like, scientifically and then try applying this to a lot of aquariums. It was more that the owner of American Aquarium, my mentor, Carl Strohmeyer, saw all these results from keeping thousands of aquariums from the largest and oldest maintenance company in the U.S. based out of California. And by having so many applications over so many decades of time, it really allowed for adjusting of a variable, seeing a result, and when you apply it on that mass of a scale, it's no longer an anecdotal experience, it's more testing and research. So these things were happening where certain health for fish would be better or worse, depending on what was being used. And so he tried to connect the dots when he was forming American Aquarium. And now with a lot of additional research, more experiments, we have been able to conclude that oxidative stress seems to be the cause of disease in aquariums. So we spent a lot of time educating people about this. And I want to try to put this in an understandable video for you guys, hoping that it won't be long. But it may try to get scientific, but stick with me. You'll be able to understand it and have a real good university level type of understanding of how to prevent disease in aquariums. So this idea of oxidative stress can be measured in multiple ways, but the most common and most understood way is through pH. It's a very generic way. There's more detailed ways to measure this, but we can see that there's going to be something more acidic or more alkaline. What was found is that an aquarium system is different than an open system. Aquarium system is considered a closed system. Open system would be rivers, streams, oceans. There is a science that naturally happens out in the open that we don't have in our aquariums that allow acids, oxidative stress — they're almost interchangeable, even though there's some nuances to it — to build up into an aquarium and not be naturally balanced, similar to what happens out in nature. So we take these fish that have been adapted to live out in this nature that's being naturally balanced ionically, and we put them in a glass box, and we don't provide this same ionic balance. So this is more commonly known as redox, ORP, oxidative stress. That's the relative oxidative potential. That's more scientifically known. Even more commonly known, and you may be surprised that we're talking about this now, is electrolytes. Fish need electrolytes just like an athlete would. And what was found, just like an open system out in nature versus a closed system like an aquarium, is that a constant supply of these electrolytes ended up being the best for long-term health. Now, when we're talking about redox or oxidative potential, I'm kind of cutting it short when I talk about electrolytes. I tend to do that because it is one of the areas that is most well or most forgotten about, but there are other areas of redox. So one is the oxygen that we're putting into our aquariums. A lot of people say, well, that's given. Everybody has an air stone, has flow in their aquariums. oxygen is covered. And most of the time, oxygen is covered in an aquarium. Many times it could happen though, filters, the flow stops, something like that. Two is mineralization. Now mineralization is these electrolytes that is commonly missed in aquariums. And then three, when I'm talking about redox, oxidative stress, is the use of something like a sterilizer. So let's try to bring this all back around. So it was found from having thousands of applications that disease was prevented best when there was good oxygen. That's a given. Second was constant mineralization, which is kind of foreign to a lot of people, and saltwater tanks maybe not so much. And then three, the use of sterilization, which really helped as well. All these things combat oxidative stress in their own way. The electrolytes. When an open system, like a river, stream, ocean, they constantly have water running over rocks, which electrically charges as the minerals wear away into the water. This is keeping a constant charge to the fish, the surrounding body of the fish, and osmoregulation that is needed for the immunity of the fish. Immunity, once that is worn away, same as in human health, that is when disease is allowed to affect the fish. In an aquarium system, this is important, this is key, guys, we do not have that constant electrical charge. I like to describe it as like a battery with an alternator that's being constantly charged. Our aquariums are like batteries that we need to keep at a certain millivolt of electrical charge. That is often missed. And what happens is we have these abundance of oxidizers that are poured into our water, fish food, conditioners, medications, lighting, dead plant matter, dying fish, all these things add up. These things continually wear away an electrical charge, and we're not replenishing that charge. So what was found was replenishment was key. And actually what was critical, the pivotal point to Carl's research was that a constant supply. And how this is best done is either a constant drip of an electrolyte source, or even better, a block that you can just throw into the aquarium water that slowly dissolves. And we've seen this through experience and through our experiments that it is a dramatic, long-lasting combater of oxidizers. Now I'll introduce another word, reducers. These are reductions reducing to oxidizers. The redox balance is a balance between oxidizers and reducers. So when you provide this constant source through an electrolyte mineral block as a reducer, it makes it so the fish doesn't even have to have that stress because it's quickly eliminated, long lasting. And their osmo function does not have to combat the stress. This makes it easier for the fish to cope and makes it easier so they don't have to fight off disease. It continually boosts their immunity. Guys, this is what's being looked at for human cancer research. This is a big deal. So, the key point to all this is that we make sure we have a reducer to combat these oxidizers. We want oxidation, but we also want a mindset that we're not going to always put oxidizers in our aquarium. We're going to balance them with reducers as well and consider everything that we put in our aquarium. Even better, and the third part of this, was adding UVC sterilization into the mix. So even with really good oxygen, even with really good minerals, adding UVC sterilization helped combat those oxidizers in a little bit different way. And continually boosts the immunity of fish, which provided best health, combining all three of these things. Better than simple water changes. People think, well, I'll just do a lot of water changes. All these things in the experiments and the experience showed they were beat by the three keys to redox balance here. Another little aspect that I want to bring into this equation, I keep talking about how fish food turns into acid. We can look at this in a couple different facets. One, if the ingredients of the fish food are more acidic in nature, say maybe a wheat product as a binder instead of a alkalides type of vegetable pea binder, that in itself will turn more acidic than alkaline. Also, the amount of digestibility. If it's a poor digestibility and the fish is just passing it through, that in a sense is contributing to more acid buildup. And while no one's really looking at this as an experiment, these things, the simple science can be applied. So quality fish food can play a role in this redox oxidative stress balance. I want to bring this all back around to immunity. With fish and humans, it's that our immunity is worn to a certain point and then we contract the disease. With redox, the balance, these oxidizers, these stressors, it then leads to a battle that the fish has to constantly try to battle these stressors. And those, if for a weaker fish, or a compromised fish, I could say, will then lead to disease. So we have to take into account oxidative stress, but then also all stressors in an aquarium. Temperature, water flow, bullying, fish food, all these things the fish has to constantly adjust to defend itself from the ever-present disease that is in our aquariums. So we want to have a mindset that we're going to work on constantly boosting an immunity. So please keep in mind oxidative stress, the whole redox balance. Of course, take a look at the resource because I just gave you guys the snippet version. There is so much more information in the articles with backed up research, with additional testing. And again, guys, this is where the guys that are spending lots of money on their fish, this is the research they come to and go, wow, this is what I've been looking for. The people that have been putting their investment into their fish, that they're pets or they're spending lots of money, this is where they're coming to and going, this is what we need, because it helps preserve the fish longest, preventing disease. Okay? So it's a serious deal, something that we're passionate about. Please make sure to share this to your guys' aquatic friends. We really appreciate it. We appreciate you guys and your support as always. Check out all of our information on American Aquarium, Aquarium Upon Answers. Check us out in our sponsored forum, Everything Aquatic. And we'll talk to you guys next time. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.